Shit, you, I have to document this. My dog just went to, like, do a little chew on my foot, which is not unusual. She is literally deforming my feet. They're sticking out this bone. Look at that. Look at that. And this one she's done so many times. I mean, that's all swollen here. She's nuts. If the United States government, some form of it, doesn't want to put this bitch in prison for the rest of her life, they are crazy. To let her run around and influence other people. You can actually see the bruising from this angle. See that on these two fingers? You look at the knuckles, they're all swollen. This one has discolorment. This one feels super stiff. She's a torturer. She's a fucking torturer. But yeah, he just was giving me a little chew on my foot, and literally the pain was excruciating. So she's deforming my feet. Usually my veins don't stick out like that unless I've gone on like a hike or something that was strenuous on my feet. I don't normally wake up with my veins like this on my foot. Anyhow, I'm finding it impossible to find someone to fix my vehicle, my bus, my 1992 Toyota Coaster that Alex at ottoex destroyed. And I'm still guessing he took the engine out completely. I've called 15 places, storage places. They don't want to let me store it there. This is partially them, you know, blocking me. I know that. And partially it's the vehicle. But it isn't insane, you know. These engines are here in the United States. And people do work on little RVs, minibuses, whatever. So yeah. Well, that didn't take long. I just saw a blue flash over there. I say stuff like that, I know how it sounds, so it's like, that sucks. But, all I can do is say it. And if you look it up, isoflurane, when it interacts with something, I don't know if it's oxygen, something in the environment, it makes a blue flash. So if you want to know, like, Detective Briscoe at the sex crimes, assigned to my rape cases, said, how would you come up with isoflurane? I literally just Googled it. Like, that's why it's like, when people are like, this is all your delusion. How? I don't even know this stuff exists. Like, I literally didn't know anything about isoflurane. I didn't know anything about anesthetic. I had to Google all this stuff. Because when I'm waking up with severe injuries, like my entire top of my foot black and blue, I know that that's more than just being nitrous oxided, from what I read. Of course, back then, I think that they were nitrousing and then using propofol because of the injection marks I was finding on my body. This is literally a nightmare. So anyhow, I just was asked to move rooms. I guess there's a big group coming into the hotel, the Army. So, I'm finding it interesting that there's going to be people from the United States Army just staying in the room that I was just in, that literally was just blanketed with whatever this substance is, isoflurane, whatever it is. I mean, it literally was just saturated. So, I was knocked out at probably about, last time I looked at the clock, it was like 5, and I had fallen asleep for a bit. I had a dream, which usually means I'm not completely out. I don't dream when that happens at all. And I've dreamed every night for my whole life until now. And then I woke up at 8 something. So, and from the dog's reaction, and the way that they were like, that, I would guess that someone came in the room. I could hear her trying to come in when I was laying there going in and out of sleep. I drank a lot of coffee. And I could, you know, the stuff was just inundating the room. I mean, I made a video last night where I was talking on the video and then all of a sudden it got hazier and hazier and I could feel it on my skin. So as you could see it in there, and if you think I can do that, I can't even leave this hotel. Like, I can't take my dogs anywhere. They have me completely stranded here. Yeah, my option is to take it to an RV place that I'm pretty sure I can't trust anymore. I'm pretty sure. So, yeah. I'm begging people to help me. Which is, this is not how I've ever been in my life. I've never wanted to put somebody in a position of trying to get them to do something that they don't want to do. That's not been anywhere near where I'm at in my life. I mean, where it was. But it is where I'm at now. So anyhow, the dogs are super bummed. They feel super sick, and they were super freaked out. So she had 3 hours. And that's 3 hours of mostly daylight hours, or at least an hour and a half, at least half of it was daylight hours. There's no way people that work here don't know. When I went down to get breakfast, I got 4 bowls of cereal, 2 things of milk. I grabbed 3 waters because I've been drinking water out of the tap and it's meh. But don't really care. I don't really drink that much water. Whatever drug this is makes all of us thirsty but not able to drink, or not really wanting to. And I grabbed some scrambled eggs and bacon for the dogs, and a breakfast sandwich, which I didn't get yesterday or the day before, and a waffle. And the lady chastised me and said, "Are you just one person?" And I'm like, "Yep." And she's like, "Well, you know, you have a lot of food for one person. You know, we're only here to feed you for breakfast." I'm thinking, I just paid $179 for this room in a location next to a busy road with no greenery to take my dogs out on. I'm being gassed and most likely assaulted in your establishment. And and I'm stranded. Taking my vehicle 1 mile is a precarious situation. And you're chastising me because I'm taking a little bit more food than I normally should. And that, I mean, and we're talking about scrambled eggs that I saw her take out of a bag and then pound with her hand. So, not gourmet. I thought that was kind of fucked up. And she's a bitch, you know. I came in, she didn't say anything to me. I saw her yesterday. She helped me with the waffle thing. Nothing, I didn't, no bad feelings. I was joking about how I seemed to not be able to make the waffle maker work. And it didn't want to make one waffle for me without falling apart. Right now, at this point, I've spent over $400 here. And I don't want to be here. And again, it's a super crappy location. It's loud. To note last night, to cover her noise that she was making trying to get into the room, they were having vehicles drive by. It was crazy, like all night long, like loud driving by. And I'm thinking, I know this is a fairly busy road, but all night, like even freeways don't stay busy in the same section all, like, persistently, like car after car after car. And I did see a police officer go after one of them. Anyhow, I wonder how the army guys are gonna like being in a room that has a toxic or some sort of sedation chemical that's literally now on every surface of it. So because they'll vacuum probably, they'll they'll, you know, do the sheets and they'll wipe everything down. But from what I've read, isu fluorine stays on things for years. So I just can't foresee that they'll be able to get all that off, and probably won't even change the pillows. I don't know. I don't know how thorough people who do the rooms are. I don't know if COVID makes a difference. Anyhow, so yeah, we've been moved into this room, which my eyes definitely feel better already. I don't know if you can tell as the video goes on that my eyes can actually be more open, and they're definitely still coated with the stuff. I can actually feel it on my eyes. This is what's so... Anyhow. Yes, for the guy that said I constantly jump around, yeah. I am under the influence of some sort of substance 24/7. I looked at the video of me in my bus when we first got stranded, and my eyes are just bleh. And I just remember the dogs were just bleh. You know, Vita would not get up. She wouldn't go to the bathroom. She hadn't pooped all day. That's very unusual for her. You know, and yeah, she's scared because she's somewhere she doesn't know. She doesn't know who I am half the time because Crazy Crack Whore puts on my jackets and she wears glasses and masks and, you know. But it was a little worse than it normally is for them. And that would lead me to conclude that that smell, that overwhelming diesel smell, and also a chemical that I can't identify inside that bus that's in there now, despite the fact that it hasn't been driven for more than a few minutes yesterday, was just, you know, another thing that Alex at ottoex allowed these people to do with my bus, which he also allowed them to do with the rodeo, which led to my cat's death. And it did. He just couldn't. It was just too little, too old. And I'm going to make a note. I don't trust that vet that put Kitty to sleep. Even when it was, like, right before, when I knew he needed to go to sleep because whatever they did. I mean, he was even getting a little brighter in his eyes. Problem is, I didn't have anywhere for him to go. I might regret not just keeping him there and letting them do the fluids and everything for longer. But still, at the end of the day, I had nowhere to take him. But yeah, that vet, bad feeling. Bad feeling about him, you know? And it's mostly because I said, this is neurological, and I showed him a video of the dogs twitching and twitching and twitching, and he's like, I see a dog dreaming. And it's like, I'm explaining to you that literally the moment they fall asleep, or the moment they lay down, let me be more specific, they start twitching and twitching and twitching. Before they're in REM, before they're in a dream state, they're twitching, and they do that. And as the substance just gets more and more into the room, they do more convulsing-like things, and eyes roll back, and yeah, no. You know, you can't tell me, I've been a dog owner, I've been an animal owner for decades. You can't just... So the fact that... And Kitty literally was showing signs of neurological stuff, which is what the first vet, when I first brought him in there, said. That stroke, neurological, you know, and the twitching. That sort of like... I can't describe it. I can't enact it. Although my body does it right before I pass out. My cat Suela had that. I easily identified that with Kitty because my cat Suela had that after he ingested that poison, and I was told he was going to die, and then I used subcu fluids every other day for 6 months, and he survived, and then his kidneys miraculously tested fine. Same exact thing. So that's, and it's neurological. I don't have to be a scientist to see something and know that that's that. So anyhow, pretty sure she spent a lot of time up in the attic there. I don't even want to say it out loud because I know how it sounds, but there's an attic entrance down the hall that says attic access, personnel only. And I'm going to go in a little bit, and when I go to return the key to my other room that I just had to switch out of, and I'm going to show you the marks on the door where the lock is. and how they got up into the attic and how she's up there. And right before I passed out last night, or it's 5 o'clock this morning, I heard like a little bit of sawing. And this is drywall, I'm guessing. And I'm guessing, you know, they're just sawing little holes and putting whatever substance it is right through there. And they probably don't have to be big. Maybe it's around the outlets. I don't know. Don't ask me. And don't, if I'm so delusional, then why don't I know the rest of the story? Like, why don't I know the whole thing? I mean, if my mind's gone that far and this is all bullshit and this is all not real, then why have I not constructed the entire scenario? Why would I stop? Why do I have to keep trying to figure out the next thing instead of knowing in my delusional mind what it is? Done.